So we've got a developing story to talk about. The U.S. Treasury and Commerce Department, among the federal agencies that were victim of a massive cyber attack, the breach believed to be the work of the Russians. And Eamon Javers joins us with the latest. Eamon.
Yeah, good morning to you, Andrew. A lot of developing news over this overnight. But yesterday, what we knew was Reuters reported initially that there was a hack by persons unknown at the Treasury and Commerce Department. What we knew at that time was that they were monitoring email traffic inside Treasury and the Commerce's organization focused on internet policy. That attack led to a National Security Council meeting at the White House on Saturday. The investigations, Reuters reported, by the FBI and others was still in its early stages. Now, later last night, FireEye, the cybersecurity company, put out additional new details on this in several blog posts. They said that the attack was, in fact, global in scope, hitting public and private institutions around the world. It began by the spring of 2020, so this has been underway for quite some time now. They also said that the attack uses existing IT infrastructure management software that's widely used by companies and government entities to get in. It stealthily gathers information once that malware has been installed. They said that the malware actually lies dormant for about 2 weeks before beginning to gather information and report back. It's all disguised, so it's very difficult to detect. They say this was most likely a nation state. The Russians have said that it wasn't them. They deny responsibility. FireEye says there are a lot of organizations here that have been affected, and they are notifying them all right now. The federal government said overnight last night, Andrew, that they are trying to root this malware out as quickly as they can. They've ordered all federal agencies to stop using the software in question here and to make sure that this malware is stopped in its tracks. But there's a lot here that we still don't know, Andrew.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.